Praise the Lord. Welcome everyone to SIM English Worship Service. Today is 7th February. Today's scripture, we're going to look at James chapter 3, verses 7 through 12. Today's title is Lord, Tame Our Tongue. Before we begin, I'd like to start a new session, which is 3-Minute Gospel. Let's read it together. Have you ever heard about gospel? Gospel is Jesus died on the cross for our sins and was risen from the dead, and whoever believes this gospel shall be saved. But if you ought to believe this gospel, you must first know that you are a sinner. The Bible says that everyone is a sinner. Why is that so? The first man Adam became a sinner by taking God's forbidden fruit of knowing good and evil. Therefore, everyone born of him also became a sinner. You may not feel comfortable about this since you've never thought of yourself as a sinner. But if the following four categories are relevant to your life, you should acknowledge that you are a sinner. First, fear is the consequence of sin, and if you live under fear, then you are a sinner. Second, hatred is the consequence of sin, and if you have hated or hate someone, then you are a sinner. Third, trouble and pain are also consequences of sin, and if you have troubles or pains, then you are a sinner. Fourth, death is also the consequence of sin, and because you will one day face death, and you are a sinner. Sinners live under trouble, fear and sin until they die, but this is not the end. Once they die, they will surely be judged and condemned and thrown to hell. Do you know what kind of place hell is? The Bible says hell is the place of eternal torment, and once you get in, there's no way out. Because of sin, everyone will die and be judged to be condemned to hell for eternal torment. This is the doomed destiny of all people. How can we then escape from this destiny? First of all, we must find the remedy for sin. For the wages of sin is death, therefore someone must die on our behalf to pay the penalty of our sins. But we, born of Adam, are all sinners, so we cannot die for someone else. That's why Jesus Christ, not born of Adam, but born of the Virgin Mary, came into this world as righteous one, to die on the cross for our sins, and was risen from the dead. So if you believe this gospel that Jesus died on the cross for your sins and was risen for your life, you shall be forgiven of your sins and you shall be saved. Now, open up your heart and believe that Jesus died on the cross for your sins and was risen for your life and be forgiven and be saved. Amen. Now, let's pray for the world. We have persecuted churches worldwide. As you can see, North Korea, Afghanistan, Somalia, Libya, Pakistan, Eritrea, Yemen, Iran, Nigeria, India, those top 10 countries. Let's remember their names and pray for them. And also pray for unreached people groups worldwide. This map shows country size proportional to UPZ population. Maybe God sees the world this way because there are lost souls and unreached people groups there, that the love of God is definitely needed. I can see India in great number, and Afghanistan, China, Morocco, Nigeria, Indonesia, Japan, Turkey, and countries. Remember those names, and let's pray and bless them. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, full of grace and love, we pray and bless those countries, bless those names and their people. Lord, for around 20 years, North Korea topped the list of World Watch list. In the world, North Korea persecuted Christians heavily. Lord, please bless them and be with them and help and provide all their needs, their underground church, underground Christians. Lord, bless them. And as we see in these unreached people groups in the world, India has been top on the list. Lord, bless this country. And now this country is going through anti-conversion law and Hindu tobacco strategy is going on to stop Christians and wipe out Christians in the faith of subcontinent. Lord, bless this country, bless this nation and people groups so they can meet God, they can see your love. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's continue to pray for comfort and help of God for all the affected countries and areas by pandemic, war, persecution, all kinds of troubles and sadness. And let's pray for full dependence on God under all circumstances. Whatever circumstances and situations you're going through, the Lord is with you. Don't lose heart. Keep on going on your faith of journey. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. God, there are many people in the world that needs your help and your comfort. There's nothing in the world that compare your peace. Lord, we can overcome all the circumstances. Your presence is felt and experienced. Lord, let us fully depend on you, whatever circumstances are going through. There are many countries and areas that are affected by coronavirus and war and persecution, all kinds of sadness going on, and desperation, poor, poverty, famine, all problem. Lord, above all, dying without knowing you is the big Let's pray for us to encourage one another in love and care. As the days are going dark and troubled, let us encourage one another in love and care. Let's pray for Solomon Church and SIM English Worship. And let's pray for your faith group, your small group, your church leaders, and your faith community. Let's encourage one another. Let's go forward as family of God and universal church. Let's go low in prayer. Let's go. Oh God, we bless everyone who gather here and hear it near and far or online. Father God, let us encourage one another because you are the light, you are the hope, you are the life. Father God, we bless everyone in this church and worship service, and let us go forward with your love and your grace. Let us overcome all the troubles so that we can be the light to the darkness and salt in the ruined and decaying world. Thank you for this worship service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, we welcome everyone for this worship service. Today's scripture is from James chapter 3, verses 7 through 12. I'm going to read the verses for you. Starting verse 7. Remember this, people can cause all kinds of things to do what they want them to do. They have done this with animals, birds, snakes, and fish. But no person can rule his tongue. It continues to say bad things. It is like a bad poison that can cause death. We use our tongue to praise the Lord God who is our Father. But then we use it to speak bad things against other people. That is wrong, because God made those people to be like himself. This shows that we use the same mouth to praise God and also to speak bad things. My Christian friends, we should not do this. Salty water and sweet water never come from the same well. A fig tree cannot give olives, my friends. A vine for grapes cannot give figs. And a salty well cannot give sweet water. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. If you look at verse 8, it said, but no person can rule his tongue. Sometimes we may agree with this, because I never meant that. But somehow the words, the expression blurted out and I couldn't control it. And because of my expression and words and sentences, the mood and situation got worse. Once in a lifetime, or once in a day, or year, or week, we may experience that too. So we felt so sorry and regretful about that. Today's passage starts with amazing capability to tame the wild. Human beings, they can tame all kinds of things, including all the animals and insects and everything. But this tongue in our body, even though it's small, maybe not the smallest, but it's very small, but it's beyond our reach, beyond our ability, is beyond our reach. So we can learn from this that we have infinite weakness. This weakness is forever because our tongue doesn't go away. It's always with us. And we are incomplete in that sense. Incomplete. That means we need someone, we need something to depend on. If not Jesus Christ, we always turn to the world and many attractions and many self-gratification in the world. So, it continues to say bad things. It doesn't stop or pause in our wickedness that appears through our tongues. That doesn't stop. However, you are trained and try to contain these bad things in you, but it doesn't happen. As we read through, bad things here means a bad poison that can cause death. It's deadly. Not only bad, but also it can be deadly and lethal. It can kill people from inside out. Total desperation and disappointment that in the end they may commit suicide. That's what these bad things mean here. As much as this continues, the power to save us from this deadly poison should be strong accordingly. And verse 9, but then we use it to speak bad things against other people, not only to ourselves, but also it affects everyone around us. So when we open our mouth, that's so deplorable. Murder does not happen not only by physical killing, but it also happens through our own language, our own words or statement or conversation and expression that comes out of our mouth. So blaming others and hurting others with words can cause lethal wounds. That's very deadly. So remember this, blaming others. And people may answer back, I didn't hit him, I didn't kick him, so I'm okay, I'm innocent. No, blaming others, you only open your mouth, you said something to others, but it can cause death, sometimes suicide. Verse 9, that is wrong. Whatever you think, that is wrong, because God made those people to be like himself. This is a strong statement. The question here is, why should we stop injuring others verbally? Why is it wrong? What do you think? Why should we stop saying bad things and stop blaming others, stop complaining others to the point that they may feel bad and commit suicide and deadly? Why? Why should we stop? Why is it wrong? We may answer, because we are mature and moral. Someone will say, because it's not the way we love our neighbors. And other may answer, because that's against the golden rule, which is treat others as you want to be treated. Number 4, because God made those people to be like himself, as mentioned here, verse 9. Or someone may answer, because that's against the purpose of God's creation, God's purpose of God created us. Yes, all of these can be right and good answers. They're wonderful answers. Today's passage reminds us of the fact that we are created in God's image. In Latin word, imago Dei. We are created in God's image. Each and every one were created and made in God's image. That's why. That's why it's wrong to say bad things against any other people. So what should we learn from this? It's not only about our tongue, physical tongue inside our mouth. Tongue is just a tool to express something in us. What is it? All the bad things that Jesus said. Nothing comes into your mouth that make you impure. The things that comes out of your mouth make yourself impure and bad and defiled. So learn self-control through the work of the Holy Spirit. Only by the Holy Spirit we can do this. Nothing, any effort, any training cannot do this. We should remember this. Our contradictory speech often puzzles us. Yes, why did I say that? We always regret that. At times our words are right and pleasing to God, but at other times they're violent and destructive. Why should I say this? Why did I say that? We always feel sorry. Which of these speech patterns reflects our true identity? We were made in God's image, but the tongue gives us a picture of our basic sinful nature. God works to change us from the inside out. When the Holy Spirit purifies our heart, he gives self-control so that the person will speak words that please God. Let's pray also for the persecuted. As we saw in the first picture, that Eritrea is the number 6 on the list that persecuting Christians. It's titled Imprisoned in Eritrea. Christians in Eritrea continue to face imprisonment despite political changes that had many hoping for better days. Open Doors has worked with and through the local church in Eritrea since the 1990s. Our vision is to see a strong church that's holistically empowered to support one another and disciple believers so they remain faithful and reach out to others in the face of persecution. Strong church that can overcome all this hardship. So let's pray with open doors as we work to enable the church respond biblically to persecution. As you read in the book of Acts, their people, they respond to God in faith. Even though hardship and troubles and afflictions, persecution, they say, pray for us to let's be emboldened to go out there and deliver the message. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Let's pray. Oh God, you are calling all the prayer warriors to stand with the Lord, to pray for the people of God on earth that are persecuted Christians in the world. Let us bless them. Let us use our tongue and our mouth to bless them and encourage each other so that we can go hand in hand. We can walk in our journey of faith together. Lord, thank you for your blood. Through your love, we can go forward. We can pray. That's great love. You put your heart and your spirit in us so that we can show a love of the Lord is like. Thank you for today's message. Lord, pour your Holy Spirit in us so that our tongue can be tamed and we can pray and bless others and overcome personal weaknesses and complexions and troubles so that we can be living as the person pray and bless all the nations of the earth. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. May the grace of the Father God of Jesus Christ and the love of Father God and fellowship of the Holy Spirit with everyone near and far upon the persecuted churches and brothers and sisters in the world and unreached people groups and upon all the people who are going through all the hardships because of COVID-19 and all kinds of troubles, forever and evermore. Amen. Amen. Thank you everyone for joining this worship service, and I bless everyone to live a wonderful week with the Lord and blessing others, overcoming all the hardships with the love of God, and I hope to see you next week. Thank you.